50th anniversary dinner. Please take your seats and we'll get started. I hope everybody enjoys themselves. A lot of planning went into this. And without further ado, I will introduce our mayor, Mayor Bill McLeod.
Thank you. It's great to see such a great crowd of folks here. I know we have a very good time, and thank you all for coming. We have a silent auction, and you saw the benches when you walked in. These benches were made, all the material was donated, were made by a Carpenter's Local 839. Carpenters have always been involved in our community. Individuals or groups bought those benches for $100 a piece. All that money went to the Children's Advocacy Center. That was for them to have the privilege of decorating it. Tonight we're auctioning them off. And once again, all that money will go to the Children's Advocacy Center. And I urge all of you to be very generous in your donations. The checks will be written to the Children's Advocacy Center. It's a 501(c), so it is tax deductible. At this point, I'd like to call up Mark Carr and Bob McGooey to say something about the work of the CAC. Mark, Bob.
Good evening. I'm Bob McGooey, and I'm the president of the board of the CAC. I just wanted to say to Mayor McLeod and the Village of Hoffman Estates that what they're doing with auctioning off these benches is really going to be helpful to the CAC. It would be helpful in any time, but in this time, as you all know, it's even more helpful. And so the Village and the Mayor have been very strong supporters of the CAC, and we certainly appreciate all of their efforts on the Center's behalf. Now I'd like to introduce Mark Parr, the Executive Director of the CAC.
Thank you, Bob, and thank you, Mayor McLeod, for this generous sign of support for us tonight. The Children's Advocacy Center has been in existence since 1989, and the center provides services for children throughout the north and northwest suburbs who've been victims of sexual abuse, severe physical abuse, or victims of, or witnesses to domestic violence. Each year in our suburbs, more than 350 children are reported as victims, and hundreds of others observe violence in their home. And the Advocacy Center provides round-the-clock, free, confidential services, everything from assisting during the investigation of the abuse to medical exams to counseling services, court advocacy. We try to really provide whatever services children and families need to heal from the abuse. So we truly appreciate your support tonight and the support that the Village has given us throughout the years, and congratulations to Hoffman Estates. Thank you.
We received many letters of congratulations and proclamations from Congressman Bean, Congressman Roscom, who entered something of congressional record for us. And many of the neighboring communities and towns. This time I'd like to ask State Representative Fred Cresswell of Hoffman Estates to come forward with his presentation.
I have a resolution to read, and it reads as follows. It's from the State of Illinois House of Representatives, 96th General Assembly. House Resolution 614. Whereas on September 23rd, 1959, I was a year old at that time, by the way, the Village of Hoffman Estates was officially incorporated and has since been growing greatness. And whereas residents formed the Hoffman Estates Homeowners Association and saw the need for incorporation.
Whereas it was not until residents cast their votes on three separate occasions that Hoffman Estates was incorporated as a village. Whereas at the time of incorporation, the population was 8,000. And an area just under 3 square miles. Pretty close, huh, Fred? Whereas the village grew quickly, 2,000 acres were annexed by 1962, including areas that are now known as Winston Knowles, Westbury, and the Paul Douglas Forest Preserve. And whereas throughout the 60s and 70s, the village continued to grow greatly with the construction of both single-family homes and multifamily developments. Whereas office buildings were built by 1980, followed by major complexes, of including Ameritech's regional headquarters, and followed by Sears Roebuck in 1992. And I was around for all this. Whereas over the last 50 years, one of the most notable things to note, the Village of Hoffman Estates has had 7 dedicated mayors and 57 trustees. All these fine men and women are the reason the Village of Hoffman Estates has grown to such greatness. Whereas on Saturday, September 26, 2009, the Village of Hoffman Estates celebrates its 50th anniversary this evening at the Marriott Chicago Northwest, located in the western part of the village. Now therefore be it resolved that myself, the President, and the Cook County Board of Commissioners of Cook County do hereby congratulate the Village of Hoffman Estates on 50 years of growing to greatness.
I'd like to ask Ken Nelson, the mayor of our sister city of Rolling Meadows, to come forward. Ken?
And this is a note of congratulations. It's addressed to the Honorable Bill McLeod and the Village of Hoffman Estates. Dear Mayor McLeod, on behalf of the citizens of Rolling Meadows, I want to congratulate you on celebrating your 50th anniversary and wish all of you a very happy birthday. The founders of your village would no doubt be amazed at the changes that have taken place over this past half decade. The growth in population, housing, business, and retail would have been impossible to foresee in 1959. Yet they had the foresight to lay the groundwork for what has become a cornerstone community in the northwest suburbs. Our communities have so much in common. As your neighbor and colleague, it's been my pleasure to work with you on many projects of mutual interest. Hoffman Estates has always played a leadership role in our area. Again, my congratulations to everyone in your community. May the next 50 years be as exciting and productive as the past. Sincerely, Ken Nelson.
I'd like to ask Ruth Jones, the president of the Schaumburg Township District Library, to come forward.
I represent Schaumburg Township District Library to be here tonight to celebrate with all of the wonderful folks from the Village of Hoffman Estates on the occasion of their 50th birthday. Whereas the Village of Hoffman Estates was incorporated on September 23, 1959, in an area just under 3 square miles with a population of about 8,000. And whereas the Schaumburg Township District Library is proud to be a part of Hoffman Estates' theme of growing to greatness. And whereas the Schaumburg Township District Library salutes the Hoffman Estates Village as it celebrates 50 years of growth. And whereas the Village of Hoffman Estates now encompasses more than 19 square miles and 5 townships with a population of over 50,000, now therefore the Schaumburg Township District Library, its Board of Trustees, Director, and staff hereby recognizes and honors Village Mayor William McLeod, the Board of Trustees and staff on the occasion of the 50th anniversary of the Village of Hoffman Estates. Congratulations to all of you.
Now my very great pleasure, the village was able to retain a historian to write a history of the Village of Hoffman Estates. Cheryl lives in Carpentersville. She's a PhD candidate in history at NIU. She's a mother of 2 children, and she loved writing the history book. And I can assure you, Cheryl's not going to read the history book to you. I will. No. It'll be included in the gift bag you're given. So, but I would like Cheryl to come forward and say a few words, and thank you, Cheryl.
Again, I really appreciate the mayor, Joni, Bev, Karen, Patty, Doug, I could go on and on. Thank you so much for your hospitality, because I am not a Hoffman Estates resident. I live right next to it. I worked in Hoffman Estates, and so did my husband for several years, and we'll be coming back, thank God, to work in Hoffman Estates. But again, thank you so much, and I hope you enjoy the book, and thank you again. Thank you.